Assalamu alaikum dear students. Students, as you know, we are doing chapter number 4, carbon and its compounds, right? So we are dealing with the topic chemical properties, and in chemical properties we have done already the two properties, right? I hope if you remember, the first property was combustion. Combustion, we have done in complete detail. That is, combustion is about the fuels. We talk about the combustion of the fuels, and we say that all the fuels are containing the carbon and hydrogen. So dear students, we have bifurcated that into two parts, saturated and unsaturated. And further we talked about that whether you're saturated or unsaturated is going to give you the blue color flame or yellow color flame, which is complete combustion, which is incomplete combustion. So that we have completed in detail. Second property, that is oxidation. Dear student, oxidation also we have done in detail. That is, we say what is oxidation? Either the gain of oxygen or else the loss of the hydrogen. If we are gaining oxygen, we call it oxidation. If you are losing hydrogen, still we call it as a oxidation, and reverse of that in the reduction. I have given you the example also, and we have completed the oxidation where we have seen that alcohols are converted to the carboxylic acids, either by using KNO4 or you can use K2Cr2O7, that is potassium dichromate, right? Today we are going to start with the third property, and third property is very important. That is addition reaction. Now dear students, very important to notice over here that whatever the two properties we are going to do today are very important, and we are going to also discuss the difference between both the properties, because they are compared, and we have been asked many a times to write down the points about it. So when we talk about the addition, first of all let me tell you which are the compounds which can give you the addition reaction. Addition reaction can be only given by alkenes and alkynes. Now you may be asking, why only alkenes and alkynes and not alkanes? Yes, when we talk about alkenes, what are alkanes? Carbon single bonded compound, जहाँ पे carbon के सारे bond single होते हैं, we call it as a alkane. And because of it is having a single bond, it cannot go for cleavage. हम उसको break नहीं कर सकते, we cannot go for the cleavage. That is why when we talk about alkenes, carbon double bond, and alkynes, carbon triple bond. Dear student, as I say that first bond, the first bond between carbon and carbon is always sigma bond. This is new for you. Sigma, dear student, you will understand in the higher classes, it is the overlapping of the orbitals. So just now you will be not getting the clear idea, but in the higher classes it will be taught to you that how the orbitals of one element is overlapped by the orbital of the other lab and other element, and how the bonds are formed. But you have to remember, carbon first bond, first single bond is always sigma bond. Sigma bond, and here it is always strong bond. So you cannot cleave this particular bond. Apart from the sigma bond, we know that there is two possibilities: either one more bond or else two more bonds. So one more bond is labeled as pi bond. Pi bond, and dear student, those are weak bond. Each and every clear explanation will be there why the sigma is strong, why the pi is weak, but that may be taught in the higher classes. I can teach you just now also, but it is not cup of your tea. Right now you have to just remember, first bond is a sigma bond, and second or third, whatever the number of the extra bonds are going, those are the pi bonds. And we know finally we can just go for making triple bond. Four bonds are not possible. So what about the alkynes? we are having one sigma bond. How many pi bonds are there? Two pi bonds are there. Is it clear? So we can say that addition reaction is only given by alkenes and alkynes. It means that those are only given by unsaturated carbon compounds. Unsaturated carbon. Unsaturation means double bond and triple bond. Saturation. Saturated compound, in fact. Saturated carbon compounds cannot give addition reaction. They are not able to give addition reaction. Not possible. Reason behind it, it does not have any pi bond. जहाँ पे pi bond present है आप वहीं पे addition कर सकते हैं. Pi bond न हो तो addition नहीं हो सकता है. Is it clear? That is why we say that saturated carbon compounds cannot give addition reaction. When you are able to see all the bonds are single bond, addition reaction is not possible. Addition, like understand, if you are having 100 ml of water and if you are adding the sugar in there, suppose you have taken 5 gram and you have stirred it well, it is dissolved. If you are taking another 5 gram, now total 10 grams is there. You are stirring it well and it is dissolved. Now, third time when you are taking the sugar and you are dropping it into your water and you are stirring it well, still it is not dissolved. What does this mean? The capacity of 100 ml that was 10 gram of sugar to dissolve it, that is over. It means that now it has arrived saturated point. Agar aapko hum 8 periods continuous padhate hain, uske baad agar ye kaha jaye that 2 more periods will be there, dear student, you will be hesitating or you will be completely exhausted. You will be saying no more capacity to take now extra lectures. So when there is an end of any particular thing, means capacity is over, we call it saturated point. After that, addition is not possible. Okay, where in addition in these two cases, unsaturated is possible by, we can go for the cleavage. हम ये pi bond को break कर सकते हैं. तो just think and tell me how many times addition is possible in alkenes and how many times addition is possible in alkynes. If we talk about pi bonds, alkenes are having one pi bond, so addition can be done once. Alkynes are having two pi bonds, means addition can be done twice. Okay, so let us see the examples over here.
Here I have given the name and you have to draw the structure. So what you have to do,
ट्रिपल बॉन्ड, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कार्बन कार्बन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड. नाउ सी डियर स्टूडेंट, ईच ऑफ द कार्बन इज हैविंग थ्री हैंड ऑन वन साइड एंड वन हैंड ऑन द अदर साइड, दैट इज टोटल फोर हैंड्स आर देयर. कार्बन वैलेंसी इज फोर, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. इट कैन नॉट एक्सेड और इट कैन नॉट गो फॉर टेकिंग थ्री हैंड और टू हैंड्स. इट इज कंप्लीटली यू हैव टू टेक फोर हैंड्स ओनली, राइट? Suppose at the first step we are doing hydrogenation. So what is going to happen? One bond will be break. एक bond break हो जाएगा, double bond रहेगा, right? Now see, it is having one more hydrogen already. This is the original hydrogen. Now this hydrogens we are keeping it over here, right? Can it go for the addition reaction once more? Answer? Yes. Why? Still we have one pi bond. So we can go for the addition reaction once more, and we will be leading to the saturated compound, leading to the saturated compound which cannot go for the addition reaction further on. हम इसको addition reaction आगे नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि pi bond नहीं है. That is namely ethene and ethane started from ethyne. Is it clear? So we have started from ethyne, we obtained ethene, we obtained ethane. तो आपने ट्रिपल बॉन्ड में से डबल बॉन्ड, डबल बॉन्ड में से सिंगल बॉन्ड बनाया. इट मीन्स अनसेचुरेटेड से लाइट लास्ट हम किस कहाँ तक पहुँचे? सेचुरेटेड, सेचुरेटेड कार्बन कंपाउंड. Is it clear? This is all about addition reaction. Dear students, if we talk about saturated compound. अच्छा, saturated compound में addition possible नहीं है. We cannot have the addition reactions. So suppose I am having one saturated compound and I want to make some changes in this. So can I have the option of addition reaction? Addition is not at all possible. So what I can go for doing? I can remove one hydrogen and I can substitute something else. This is called substitution reaction. What does substitution means? At the place of one particular hydrogen, you are removing the hydrogen and you are bringing something else which you want at the place of the hydrogen. Now dear students, this is called substitution. Achha, ek aur important cheez. Addition reaction mein kisi bhi element ka loss nahi hota. There is no loss of any element. But substitution mein hydrogen. You have to lose the hydrogen, then only you can gain something. For example, chlorine. Okay, we want chlorine at one of the. Now, dear student, in this case, what will happen? Not both the chlorines can be occupied over here. You have to take, suppose, one hydrogen out of here. As you have two chlorine, one chlorine will be attached with this one, resulting into HCl. यहाँ पे आपका एक HCl molecule बन के निकलेगा. हाइड्रोजन अकेला नहीं निकल सकता. इट रिक्वायर्स अनदर एलिमेंट टू गो फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कंपाउंड, बिकॉज सिंगल हाइड्रोजन इज हैविंग ओनली वन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड द वैलेंसी इज नॉट फुलफिल, राइट? सो इट रिक्वायर्स वन मोर इलेक्ट्रॉन विच कैन बी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाई द क्लोरिन. सो एट द प्लेस ऑफ दिस, सी नाउ इट इज वेरी मच बैलेंस्ड वन. आउट ऑफ टू क्लोरिन एटम्स वन इज अटैच विद हाइड्रोजन रिजल्टिंग इनटू HCl. एंड एट द प्लेस ऑफ दैट हाइड्रोजन यू हैव टू कीप ऑन दैट सेम प्लेस the remaining chlorine atom. So you will be getting this type, this structure. Okay, how do we name it? I have taught you that how do we go for writing IUPAC names of the compounds. So as we have two carbons, it as all the bonds are single bond, ANE, ethane, and as you have the chlorine as one of the functional group, how do we write chlorine? Prefix or suffix? We write it as a prefix. So we will write it as a chloroethane. Chloroethane. Now you will be asking me that, ma'am, how many times we can go for substitution? You can go for substitution number of times. As many hydrogens are present over there, that many times you can go for substitution. अब जितने hydrogen present हैं उतनी बार substitution कर सकते हैं. So we can say that this can go for substitution reaction. But dear student, one more important thing, when you are doing addition reaction, when you are doing, suppose you are having ethene, when you have ethene, it can go for addition reaction also and substitution reaction also. Tell me why? Addition, it is having the pi bond, so it can go for addition reaction. And substitution, because it has four hydrogens, so you can say that your most reactive compounds are your alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes and alkynes, alkane ki comparison mein zyada reactive hote hain. Suppose aapko ye koi bhi competitive exam mein pucha jaye that why the alkenes or alkynes are more reactive, or else they may give you alkene, alkene and alkynes, and they may ask you which is most reactive. So your answer goes over here that alkynes are more reactive than alkenes, because you are having triple bond and hydrogens also. So it can go for addition reaction also and substitution also. So alkynes are more reactive than alkenes, which are in turn more reactive than alkanes. Alkanes can only give substitution reaction. I hope you are getting both the properties properly, that what is addition reaction and what is substitution reaction. Substitution mein hydrogen ka loss hai. या आप ये कह सकते हैं कोई भी एलिमेंट आपको लॉस करना पड़ेगा तब जाके आप सब्स्टिट्यूशन कर सकते हो, जबकि हाइड्रोजन में एक भी एलिमेंट का लॉस नहीं होता है. यू हैव टू कम्प्लीटली जस्ट क्लीव द पाई बॉन्ड एंड यू हैव टू गेट द प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म्ड ओवर हियर. आई होप यू आर गेटिंग दिस टॉपिक क्लियर. एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, स्टिल इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क एंड यू कैन क्लियरिफाई योर डाउट्स.